Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. If you've not already done so, we suggest that you watch the videos on Intro to Gravity and Balanced and Unbalanced Forces before watching this video. On Earth, this astronaut weighs 150 pounds, but on the Moon, he weighs only 25 pounds. His body is so light compared with his leg strength that it's easy for him to jump high and move quickly. Although his weight on the Moon is much less than his weight on Earth, his mass is the same in both places, which is about 68 kilograms. In everyday life, we usually think of pounds and kilograms as measuring how heavy something is. For example, this dumbbell is 11.25 kilograms, which is about 25 pounds. So, how is it possible that an astronaut's weight drops 125 pounds when he's on the Moon, yet he's still 68 kilograms? To answer that question, in this video, we'll learn the definitions of matter, body, mass, force, weight, apparent weight, and weightlessness. We'll start with the word matter. Matter is made of tiny particles called atoms. This drop of water is made of many atoms that are too small for us to see individually. Matter can be in many states. For example, here's water in the solid state, which we commonly call ice. Here's water in the liquid state. And here's water in the gas state, which we commonly call steam. Likewise, everything we touch from furniture to furry pets are examples of matter. We're made of matter, too. In everyday use, if someone seems upset, we might ask them, "What's the matter?" In that context, the word matter refers to a thought or a problem. But in science, we don't count thoughts or ideas to be matter. Matter is made of atoms. Ideas aren't made of atoms. Likewise, light is not made of atoms. So, light is not matter. Next, we'll discuss the word body. In science, we use the word body to refer to a specific collection of matter. A body could be living, like people and plants. Or a body could be non-living, such as a boat. A body could be very small, like a single grain of salt. Or a body could be very large, like an entire planet. We can define specific bodies based on our needs. For example, even though there are a lot of individual people in this plane, when we're studying the plane's motion, we consider everyone inside it, plus the plane, to be just one body. Next, we'll introduce the word mass. In science, we use the word mass to refer to an amount of matter. This child has a mass of 15 kilograms. This lamb has a mass of 5 kilograms. So long as the amount of matter stays the same, then the body's mass will also stay the same. We measure a body's mass using a balance and describe this in units of kilograms, or parts of a kilogram. To find the mass of this pipe, we can keep adding discs with no mass amounts until the balance is balanced. In this case, we needed 70 grams to balance this pipe. We would write the mass as 0.07 kilograms or as 70 grams. Next, we'll talk about the word force. A force is an influence that, if unbalanced, can change the speed or direction of a body. This man is pushing a car when its parking brake is off, so the car moves. We say he's exerting an unbalanced force on the car because he has changed its speed from going 0 miles per hour to going half a mile per hour. We often measure force in pounds. This winch has a pulling force of 2,500 pounds. This grader has a pushing force of 30,000 pounds. This man is exerting a pushing force of 25 pounds on this scale as he pushes it against the wall. In contrast to using a balance to measure a body's mass, we measure force using a scale. Scales often have springs inside them. This is a Newton force meter, which is just a spring inside a case with markings. Each unit of force is called a Newton. Now we're ready to discuss weight. The word weight refers to a force on a body that is caused by gravity. This plate has a mass of 11.25 kilograms. The scale says the plate weighs 25 pounds. On Earth, this astronaut weighs 150 pounds. On the Moon, his weight drops to only 25 pounds. That's because the Moon's gravitational force is much less than the Earth's. On Jupiter, he would weigh 375 pounds. That's because Jupiter's gravitational force is much greater than the Earth's. Please note that in all three places, his mass is the same. That's because his amount of matter stays the same. Technically, this astronaut couldn't stand on Jupiter because it's made of gas rather than rocks. But we'll overlook that point for this video. The moon's low gravitational force makes the astronauts and their equipment weigh much less than they do on Earth. Their weight is so low that it's easy to launch them from the surface of the moon. In comparison, bodies on Earth are 5 times heavier than they are on the moon, so we need huge rockets to launch astronauts from Earth. Here's a quick quiz. This lady has a weight of 181 pounds. Is that a measure of the amount of matter in her body? No. Mass would be a measure of the amount of matter in her body. The value of her weight tells us the amount of force acting on her body that is due to the Earth's gravity. Please try to name the contents of each cell in this summary table. We encourage you to pause the video if you need more time. This is the most important screen in this video. In your chemistry courses, you will use measuring devices that may look like scales, but they are balances. They work in a different way than scales, and they measure mass, not force. Next, we'll discuss apparent weight. The term apparent weight refers to the size of contact forces that are supporting a body against gravity's force. If you've ever ridden a fast elevator, you may have noticed that the pressure on the soles of your feet changes based on what the elevator is doing. You feel these pressure changes in your feet when your apparent weight changes. To illustrate apparent weight, let's see what happens to this man in an elevator. This man weighs 150 pounds. If he takes off his shoes and steps on a scale when inside the elevator that is still, the scale reads 150 pounds. That's because the scale is pushing up against the man with 150 pounds of force to prevent him from falling. If that elevator drops quickly, then his apparent weight initially decreases from 150 to 140 pounds. That's because now the scale is only pushing up against him with 140 pounds of force. But if he rides in an elevator that goes up quickly, his apparent weight will increase to 160 pounds for just a moment. That's because now the scale is pushing on him with a greater force. Our final topic will be to discuss weightlessness and free fall. Every astronaut, everything inside the International Space Station and the space station itself, has an apparent weight of 0 pounds. When a body has an apparent weight of 0 pounds, we say it is weightless. To understand how this happens, let's return to an elevator example. When this elevator is still, the floor is supporting this man's full weight. If he was standing on a scale on the elevator's floor, it would show that his apparent weight is 150 pounds. But if the elevator's cable went completely slack, then the elevator and the man would both fall down the elevator shaft very fast. They would fall so fast that he would seem to float inside the elevator. The elevator floor and scale are not supporting him, so his apparent weight is 0 pounds. That means he's weightless. If a body has no forces acting on it that are opposing gravity, then it's in a state of free fall. Here's a snapshot view to show motion in an instant of time. He is weightless because he's in a state of free fall. Although we commonly describe the space station as orbiting the Earth, another way to look at this is that the space station and the bodies inside it are in a continuous state of free fall. They are free falling around the Earth at over 17,000 miles per hour. Because they're in free fall, all the bodies inside the space station and the space station itself are weightless. Please note that although their apparent weight is 0 pounds, they are still under the influence of gravity. Like the moon and satellites, the space station orbits the Earth because the Earth's gravity keeps it close by, rather than letting it fly away and travel far from us in some direction across the universe. Although we commonly call the space station a microgravity environment, please note that it is still very much within the influence of the Earth's gravity. The actual weight of the astronauts is about 90% of what their weight would be on the surface of the Earth. Their mass is exactly the same as what it would be on Earth. Here's a summary of this topic plus some additional information. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.